Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to paint some April birth month flower, that is daisy flower, and I'm going to paint this with different perspective of the flower. And I'm using 300 GSM watercolor sheet. So let's start with the first perspective. So for the first one, we need some semi-circle kind of shape. So it is not exact circle. So it is kind of semi-circle shape, and the second one is exact circle kind of shape. First perception with semicircle, another perception with circle, the third one is kind of triangle, so you can keep it like a triangle shape. And the fourth one, you can keep it like oval shape. So these are my four flowers. Now for the first one, we another circle. So if you divide this circle into four equal halves, you will get the center. So we don't want center, so below to that particular center we need another semicircle. So this is the ovary of the flower, and the distance between the smaller circle and the bigger circle, you need to create petals. So bigger distance, you have to create bigger petals or longer petals, and a smaller distance for smaller petals. Likewise, this one is the ovary of the flower and the petals. This one is the ovary of the flower. This is the normal perspective. So the ovary of the flower is also circle only. And in this flower, we can't see the ovary of the flower, the outer part of the ovary and the sepals. So I'm not going to draw everything with the pencil, so I'm keeping it like that, and we're going to start with the painting. So let's rub the pencil mark a little bit. So for the ovary of the flower, I'm using yellow color and brown color. So first fill the ovary with the yellow color, and then with the help of brown color and fine brush, you can add little dots around it. So it gives a nice texture to the ovary of the flower. And then, as we have white flower today, so obviously we cannot paint white color upon the white sheet. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use very light shade of gray or blue color. So I'm using white color, little hint of black, little hint of blue, and keeping this color like very light shade of gray. So it is like very light shade of gray or blue, you can say. So now start painting your petals. Apply little pressure into your brush and start painting your petals. So longer distance, longer petals. So in this area we have to paint longer petals like this. I'm using size 8 brush to paint everything, to paint stems, leaves, petals and all those things, because I have control and I can paint bigger things, smaller things, all those things. So if you don't comfortable with bigger brush, you can use a smaller brush for smaller things and bigger brush for bigger things. It's totally up to you. Little dark shade at the edges. Now paint smaller petals in this particular area. can do some overlapping of petals, but make sure your previous petals have dried completely so that you can see the overlapped petals. Once done with the petals, what we need to do is, with the dark shade, we just need to highlight all the petals and add some line in between the petals. So I'm using size 8 brush only, and using the tip of my brush to add these small line or these thin line. So I'm not applying any pressure, I'm just using the tip of my brush to do it. Not comfortable doing this with a bigger size, you can use smaller brush as well. So do not apply any pressure if you are using bigger brush, and apply or highlight all the petals that you have. Now we are done with the first flower. Now start with the second and the third one, for which we can see the ovary. For the fourth one we cannot see the ovary, so we can paint that little in a different way. So add yellow color for the ovary of the flower, and then use brown color to add little dots around the ovary. Now with the help of same shade, so I'm using black color, blue color, white color, and creating very light shade of gray, or you can say very light shade of blue to create this petal. So this perception is straight, so all the petal size is quite same. So I'm first layer is at distance, so I'm keeping all the petals at distance. Now I'm going to add one more petals in between. I think now you understand the theory between how we can paint this flower. So this perception is, we can see the ovary of the flower towards upward and the petal is falling towards downward. Now for the fourth one, as we cannot see the ovary of the flower, but we can see the outer area of it, so I'm using sap green and little hint of yellow color to make sepals and outer area of the ovary. And with the help of same shade, create petals again. So this is the fourth perception. Now we can highlight all the petals with the dark shade of gray. So I'm using size 8 brush only, and I'm using tip of my brush. You can use fine brush as well. We we are using white sheet and we are painting white color daisy flower, so it's important to highlight all the flowers with little dark shade. We are done with all the four flowers. Now it's time to add stems and leaves. So for the stems, I'm applying little pressure to create little thicker line as compared to the previous one. And now it's time for leaves. So for the leaves, what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply a little pressure to create a structure like this, and then going to attach number of leaves like this. So extended structure and attach with the main structure, and you will get something like this. You need to repeat this process for other leaves as well. So create multiple one stroke leaves and attach all those with each other to create single leaves like this. And we are almost done with this painting. So hope you have liked this video. Hope you have learned something from this video. Do let me know if you guys have any feedback for me. And thank you so much for all your love and support. And thank you so much for watching. See you guys in the next video.